Check, check. How does this sound? Does it sound good? All right, great. There's certainly other times I've spoken about conveyor cropping where we have towers, right, in a row. And because they're modular, we can move these around. And we manage them from front to back by generation. So we've got little baby plants here, little baby plants, oh, so cute. And then we've got our most mature plants in the back, right? And what this does is, especially in northern climates where our sun angle is typically pretty low, like that. Oh man, I'm gonna draw all over the top of everything. When our sun angle is low and this sun is coming down like this, it means that we're managing so that there's not that much light obstructed in the front, right? So this front row, all these little baby plants are just consuming a very small amount of light, the light that hits them. And the rest of this light kind of just bounces back or passes between the towers, and it feeds these plants further and further to the rear. Now, by the time you get back here, those of you who have done conveyor cropping know that by the time you get back to these big mature plants in the back of the mass, a lot of the time there isn't much light back here. This is pretty darn shady, right? Back behind this tower. So spacing is really important. Now the rule of thumb with ZipGrow towers is usually between 18 and 22 inches, side to side and back to back, center to center. Okay, so from here to here, we're usually talking 22 inches. And from here to here, usually 22 to 18, right? So 22 to 18 and 22 to 18, side to side, front to back. This roughly comes out. I like to be super generous, super conservative, and make sure that we're not over-representing anything, that we're giving people the best, the most reasonable numbers. So that ends up being basically 2.5 square feet per tower. Okay,